So when we started making this game, it's been in production for, you know, a good few years, and at the time we were developing the early stages of it, we were looking at different types of engines that we wanted to use. We had a very definite idea for a game we wanted to create. We knew we had to have rich, detailed, you know, claustrophobic environments with a lot of, you know, bits and pieces and greebles everywhere. So we needed an engine that could support that. We actually figured, well, the code team could probably make exactly tailored needs for this engine if we could create our own. So by creating an engine alongside the game, we were able to really maximize the focus of the engine to support the game we were making.
One of our proudest, I think, achievements on the graphics tech is our lighting, which works very, very well for kind of our needs, which are kind of dark environments with lots of kind of dynamic lights, you know, flickering, flashing, you know, rotating lights. And all the kind of bounced GI from that, including the player torch. So as you're kind of looking around the area with your torch, you get kind of realistic interactions of that light in the world. We make a lot of use of compute shaders in our game. This kind of ranges from the radiosity solution and kind of filling cube maps, you know, in a massively parallel way. This also goes across to our GPU particle system, which specifically uses compute shaders to update, you know, thousands, if not, you know, up to a million particles. Lots of sparks bouncing across the environment, and lots of embers kind of rising up and kind of flowing in a very kind of natural way. We have a deferred system which is not traditionally good at lighting alpha objects, but lighting kind of, you know, steam in a corridor with, you know, dynamic lights it's very important to the atmosphere that they react correctly. So we effectively render out our particles into a separate G buffer, and so we kind of apply our lights directly on top of that in the same way we would other items in the world, other objects, solid objects in the world. This kind of gives the light reaction onto particles a very kind of, you know, realistic look and proper kind of volumetric sense to them.
How can I help you?
We've worked with AMD from the beginning on Alien Isolation. It's been key to allow us some insight into their tech. We've worked really closely with their engineers, and I think the final result really shows that.
They've been invaluable in terms of you know, testing and profiling and really kind of nailing down to where we were having kind of performance issues. We think, you know, our game performs really well across, you know, a wide variety of cards, not just the top end, but, you know, all the way through the, you know, through the product line.
We don't have a lot of to and fro between us and AMD with trying to get the best out of the engine and specifically stuff on PC. I think you can look at the lighting tech and just the ambient refraction of some of the world is absolutely incredible in places. And it's almost so good that it's been called out in a lot of reviews, which I was really happy about, because people can see the amount of time and effort, not just the lighting guys, but the engineers have put into making this world feel real, has all come out in the lighting and the effects. It's been brilliant. I think the more that developers go into creating these detailed and rich, you know, 4K worlds, the more people will need more memory on their graphics cards and things like that to boost up the abilities of their machine to really, like, take advantage of what we've been able to create.
When you walk up to a poster, you know, you can really read the words on it and not just think of it as kind of background information you're not meant to read. You know, this is you know, a world we want you to explore and we want you to kind of look at in close detail. So having that extra text in memory and, you know, as much as possible really, so that we can give you this detail is, you know, quite important to us.
I always give my wife a lot of hassle when she just runs straight past a room that someone's spent months creating, and I go back and look in there. That's one guy's work, you know. So I think that seeing that in its full glory and detail is really important.
We never set out to remake the original. It was more the tone of the 1979 classic that we wanted to capture. I think Alien, the original movie, has influenced a lot of stuff out there, but it seems that nobody had really gone back to the roots of the original Ridley Scott vision, this sort of dystopian used future.